Hi. So we want to see how to create text file and add date to the file name dynamically. So for that, what we need, we just create. I created a package, create flatfile.dtsx. So once you have that, you can drag and drop data flow task into the control flow window. Once you have data flow task, you can double click on it, go further, and drag and drop your OLDB source. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use our existing tables from the database to create a flat file. So now I'm going to create my OLDB source with my database first. So this is your connection manager. I'm creating the connection to my database. Okay, I already have the data connection. If you don't have it, you can go to new and then put your server name. You can get your server name from your SQL Studio. You can click on connect database engine and then copy this local server. What is your server name? My server name is local. So once you have it, you can copy it and then you can paste it here on the Visual Studio screen. So paste it, then you can use whatever your authentication mode, and then you can use your tables, whatever like database you want to use, not table, database, and then you can test connection if it's working proper or not. So I have this here done before. I can add it. Once I add connection to the database, I can view all the tables in the database. So I'm going to take human resources.employees. I selected the table. I can preview it here, and I'm gonna move to the next tab, that is columns. So once you go to the column, you can select the columns which you needed in the text file. So I can uncheck all those columns which I don't need it. So I'm gonna uncheck national ID, modified dates. So you can uncheck whatever you want and keep check on like whatever column you want, and uncheck those you don't want. So I selected like some columns, and if you see here, your login ID length is 256. So suppose this is too long for the text file. Suppose I don't need this long length. I just want a 10 like length. The length of the login ID I need is only 10 character or whatever it is, 10 or 20. So what I can do is to change the length. I need to first, okay, we'll see this, click OK. Oh no, we can see error output. So you can hear like error and truncation. So what happens if there is an error in the component, this OLDB component, source component, then it will fail the component. So your package will fail. So suppose if I do the truncation, I said like login ID is 256 and I shorten it to 10 character, then I need to set this property to the ignore failure. So I will set this property to ignore failure because I'm going to truncate my input column to 10. So I did here ignore failure, and now I can click on OK. So whatever you do the truncation in the input column, you need to select ignore failure, or now you can click OK. So now what I want to do is I want to shorten the login ID name, like the length of the shorten. So I can go to the advanced editor, and then I can go to input and output properties tab, and then here I can select output column. In output column I have login ID of 256. I can make it to 10. Now whenever I take the login ID column, there are only 10 characters going to come into the field, and the package will not fail because I set the package property to the ignore failure. So once I have this thing, so you can like if you are doing truncation in the table, you can select that thing. Now what you have is you need a destination, flat file destination, drag and drop. Once you have it, connect it to the connected data pipe to flat file destination is this. Now double click on it. Once you double click, this override data in the file is like, you need to check it. If you are writing the, if your file name is not dynamic, and suppose you run it once, then the file is going to be there at the destination. So you need to check it so that this package runs and it overwrites every time. Or if you don't want to overwrite, you need to make the file name dynamic. That's what we're gonna see, how to make the file dynamic. So we can click here, new connection. So here are like few options: delimited, fixed width, row delimiters and then regged, right? So delimited is like your columns are delimited by commas and rows are separated by new line character. So whenever you select delimited, your columns and rows are separated automatically, but in fixed width you need to separate your columns by width and there is no row delimiters at the end. But if you select this one, fixed width with row delimiters, there is a row delimiters at the end of every row, but you need to select like length of column for every column, like what length you need for every column. And regged right is same as this one, the upper one. Just the difference is this upper one has an extra column at the end with end of field, like a new line character, but this one don't have any extra field. So we gonna go with like the common one, delimited one, and then click OK. Once you click OK, you will be having this connection manager. You can put your connection manager name whatever you want. You can give the description for the connection manager what you're doing. Then here you need to give the destination, like where do you want to save your file. So I will do it here and save it as a, suppose, HR_employee details. Once I save it, so now every time when I run this package, the file is going to save into that folder. Now this one is like a language. If you want to do any other language, you can select it as Unicode and select the language. And so these are all different languages. If your database is in different language, you need to select the proper language and you need to click on Unicode. Once you have that, this one is like the code for your English language. So for English it's 1252. You don't need to play with any of these things unless and until you are working with an English database. So this is like the format which you selected. You can select it here also, like delimited, fixed width, or rect width if you selected the wrong ones earlier. Now what happens, this is important, the text qualifier. I'm gonna put double quotes. Why this is needed? Suppose I'm making delimited files, comma delimited file. So if there are any fields like address where we put the comma after a line or something, so you need to make your column in double quotes. Suppose there is comma, that won't be treated as two columns. So this text qualifier will intact your column, whatever is the information in that. So this columns are separated by now two double quotes and whatever comes in between is complete, whether there is commas it doesn't matter. So double inverted commas will give you a single column. This is your row delimiter. If you want to skip any of the rows, you can increase it. If you want to leave like top 5 rows, you can set it to 5. Now if you want to include the column name from the database, what the column names were there, you can click it here and check it. So your first row in the text file would be your column name. Now if you move to the columns, you can select, suppose if you don't want to select a text qualifier there, you can do here is like pipe delimited file vertical bar. So whatever, if there is any comma in the address line and you don't want to put text qualifier, you can use vertical bars also to separate your columns. Now when you go to advanced, then here you can select the output. I mean, like suppose if you want to change the string or like the data type, you can put it to string. And suppose if you want to change the length of the column, so here you can change it. If you want to add like a new column, you can do it here. And suppose if you want to add another column like a get date, you can add a new column here and supply the value from the data column. So and preview here, you can preview what columns are coming in. So once you are done with this, you can click on OK. And you need to go on mapping here and see if it's all correct before, otherwise you need to come here once before click on OK. You see everything is good, then click on OK. So this now here we have like connection made to the flat file. So if you run the package, it will send all your rows. See, all the rows are sent to the text file at the destination. Here is our file hrinfo_details. See what I did, this was 256. Now I just need, like, suppose the few initial characters of the column. I only selected those ones. So you need to put the ignore failure there in the truncation. And if you're going to show advanced editor, you need to put the length of 10 in output column of login ID. So here the file is created, and see, like, this double quotes are there. So suppose if there is like an address and have a comma here, so this will treat this as a two column. So to avoid this, we can use this. Or if you don't want to use the text qualifier, like double quotes, you can use a by delimiter. So if there are any commas in the field, that won't treat as a two columns. So once we create it, we don't save it. Now we'll go again to here. So now what I want to do is I want to create a dynamic file name, like with a date. So I need to click on connection manager, flat file connection manager, what we made. And then we need to go to expression. If you click on expression, there is a this dot will come, and you need to click on that, and you need to select a property that's a connection string. Once you click on it, go to expression, and here you need to type the expression for dynamic file name. So whatever, if you remember when we went to the clicked on new one previously, and we selected the browse thing and put the directory there, like selected the directory where we want to save the file. So that we want to do it here, so we can have file name dynamically. So I have my expression here. I can, so what I did is I saved the first like folders where I'm going to save it. Now this is my file name initials bi, so this is the folder in e drive SQL bi practice folder. You need to put double backslash and you need to put in double quotes whatever is your hard coded. So this is my hard coded. So if I see, this is an expression viewer in Visual Studio. You can see it will show me the path. So it's E in SQL BI practice, and BI is my initial name of the file. Now I want to append the date to it. So you need to remember, you need to put double quotes and a double slash in the path. So once I have this thing, I need a date part to append to it. So what I can do is I can copy this thing and paste it here. I will show you what I did. So what I did, I took the get date function, and I'm getting the month from it, extracting the month from the get date. But for that, you need to change this into string. So there is a function called dti_str that change this to string, and the length of the string is 2 and the 1250 is the code page of English. So I did this thing, and so this is converting this thing into string. And then again I need to select a day. I selected the day from here. If you want to select the year, you can just put year and copy as it is this thing from here to here. And you can, suppose I want to put it here also, so I can do this, just copy and paste, and I can put year here. Here, and in the end I need to put in double quotes, I need to put .txt. So how my there is an error. Okay, so here is like 4 lines, so I need to put it 4. See, that's it. For month you need to put 2, for day you need to put 2, and for this you need to put 4. So bi today's date is like month is 1st January 19 2013. So this is how you can create your text file with dynamic. You click it OK, click it OK, and so now if I run this package, my file will be created, and with the name of BI19 2013. So if you run every day, your file won't be replaced, and you can keep track of all the files.